Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries.
Hi there, I am Rachel with On the Lam All Breed Herding in Camarillo, California. So the Rough Collie is the refined show ring version of the original archetypal Collie of the British Isles. A Rough Collie and a Smooth Collie are actually two varieties of the same breed. The rough coat gene is dominant, so you can have litters that can have all rough coats, or you can have litters that can have rough and smooth coats. The word Collie is so old, and this kind of dog is so old, that we don't even know where the word Collie comes from. It could be a corruption of a word that means useful dog, or it could also be a corruption of the word for collie, meaning a black dog, because some of the original ones were black or black and white. Collies date back hundreds and hundreds of years, but the Rough Collie specifically dates back to the mid-1800s when Queen Victoria and Prince Albert were starting to develop livestock shows and agricultural shows, and the actual confirmation dog show was born. At this point, they started trying to take existing breeds of dogs and refine them and make them fit an ideal. So with the Rough Collie, they wrote up a breed standard for the working collie that should symbolize the ideal collie. This is what everybody should be breeding for. They decided they needed thick fur to protect them in the winter and tipped ears to keep their ears warm in the cold. And they needed to have a long nose to help them see a great distance. And from there, they've created the collie that we know and love today. Now, the archetypal collie was also used to develop several other breeds. Some of the ones that came to North America were used to develop the Australian Shepherd and the English Shepherd. The ones that went to Australia were used to develop the Australian Cattle Dog, the Australian Kelpie, and the Australian Coolie. The ones that stayed home back in the hills working were eventually given the name Border Collies, but the ones that were taken and refined and turned into this stunningly beautiful dog for the show ring became the Rough Collie. This started in the 1850s, and then in about the 1890s, it became very fashionable for them to have these longer noses. So some people think that they had Borzooi mixed in, or possibly some other breeds, but it's all Collie. They just decided that's what people bred for, and they bred for these big, beautiful ruffled manes and this long hair, and that's how they developed the breed that we know today. Today's Rough Collie is a lot of generations away from dogs that were needed to be used to work for a living, but they still retain a lot of their original working abilities because it's very hard to get rid of that. So a working Rough Collie is absolutely capable of gathering up sheep and moving them around in a useful fashion. In fact, they are still used on some farms today. Today's Rough Collie retains most of the amazing intelligence that working dogs need to do their job. You can see that in famous dogs from TV like Lassie, dogs that were taught to do tons of different tricks and amazing behaviors. Rough Collies retain most of the intelligence that they need to do their jobs on the farm, but they tend to have a little bit lower energy, and they tend to make better pets than dogs that are very busy and were bred specifically to do jobs all day. They like having a job, but they don't need to be herding sheep 8 hours a day to keep them happy. The Rough Collie is an upright breed. They move sheep around by moving their bodies, barking, bouncing, and doing whatever they need to do to get them moving along. They don't have the strong stare like the Border Collie does. If you have a bunch of sheep and you need to move them around very efficiently, a Rough Collie is probably not your best choice. But if you have a small home flock, that's where the Rough Collie excels as a general farm companion. They also make excellent therapy dogs and service dogs as well. When a dog first sees sheep, they just light up. It's this amazing feeling like, where has this been all of my life? And it really gives them a chance to activate a part of their brain that nothing else does. So they have the opportunity to control movement in a way that is very satisfying to them. And this helps in a lot of ways. It helps them, anxious dogs feel like they're in control of something. It helps busy dogs settle their minds down. And it's like therapy for dogs. The biggest health issues that face collies are genetic issues that can be tested for, like progressive retinal atrophy and collie eye anomaly. They can also have a potential for shoulder issues with cartilage and, of course, hip dysplasia, which is why it's always important to get a dog from parents that have been thoroughly health tested. Rough collies thrive on attention and activity. They love to do tricks, they love to be with you, and they love to do things. They make excellent hiking companions, they love going for a walk around the neighborhood, and they generally love people. The Rough Collie is an amazingly beautiful show dog that has been beloved by people all over the world. In fact, a Rough Collie sold in 1900 for what at the time was the record price for a show dog. At the time it was $10,000. That'd be roughly equivalent to $5 million now. And they've just gotten more and more popular. You see them on TV with books like Lassie. Loads of books. They're in art. They're everywhere because people just love them. They make fantastic family pets, and they're much more manageable dog than dogs like Australian Shepherds and Border Collies that need to work all the time. Your collie can be happy being a pet. They can be happy going for walks, going to the park, playing ball, and learning silly pet tricks. This is Rachel with On the Lam Herding. We're in Southern California. If you have a dog of a herding breed, or even kind of a not so herding breed, and you'd like to bring them out to see what they can do, we'd be happy to see you guys. You can check out our website at onthelamherding.com. Come on out and see us.